not the...
The reenactors of the 10th Cavalry, Buffalo Soldiers.
We have the Phoenix, Arizona Buffalo Soldiers. Arizona. They're the 5th Cavalry. They're going to open up the 1995 Rondo Drill Team Competition. All the way from Phoenix, Arizona. Let's give a little watch. History in the making, history from the past. Now we're singing the National Negro Anthem. That's our board member, Miss Vera Daisy, our board member.
Let our rejoicing break our silverly sky.
That's Miss Vera Daisy singing the National Negro Anthem. Lift every voice and sing is the title of the song. Doesn't she sound lovely? Got Mr. Herman Lewis making announcements, another member of the Rondo board, also our drill, also our entertainment chairperson.
African American Cultural Clown Club. Please welcome them.
This is Hershey and Carmel and friends, first and only Afro-American Clown Club in the country. They're going to let off the balloons that simplify the African-American colors and Africa colors. And there goes the Buffalo Soldiers marching under the goal to march off the field.
In 5, 4, 3, 2.
We're getting ready to let go of the balloons. It's going to be a beautiful sight. There they go. Oh, that's beautiful. That's nice. Here we are at the 1995 Remember Rondo Drill Team Competition. It's beautiful to see all these people together under one common goal, and that's to unite the communities of both cities, Minneapolis and St. Paul. And as your announcer, my name is Bobby Johnson. I'm the drill team chairperson, also a Rondo board member. This year, new to Rondo, we have a quarter path mat that the drill teams have the option of using to drill on. Or they can also drill in front of the mat, because it is a little wet from the rain that we had earlier today. So we gave them that option. But the mat is there, so they don't have to be marching on wet grass. And there they go. Getting ready to line up, get started. Each team has 13 minutes to perform.
Everybody that came Well, let's go do it. So we're going to get rid of it. I'll take it with me.
Starting off. Des Moines, Iowa, the Isiserettes.
Thanks, Bill.
This is Des Moines, Iowa's Isiserettes. This is their first year at the Rondo competition. And I'm sure that the crowd will give them a nice warm welcome as if they have been here before and as if they lived here. Oh, that sounds nice. That's a nice beat. They have the guys on the drums and the ladies marching. I'm so happy that the weather broke for us so we can do this competition and bring it to you, our cable access fans. This is what Remembering Rondo's all about. Unity in both cities together. Kids practice all year long. It takes countless of hours to get the precisions of these steps down, to get the beats of the music down, and to be able to dance and drill to it. These kids love to perform. If it was snowing today, they would still go out there to perform. That's what they practice for all year round. And it shows. Look at them. Nice formation, right in unison with each other. That's a nice formation. Isiserettes Drum and Drill Corp from Des Moines, Iowa. This is their first year at the Rondo's 1995 Drill Team Competition. The Isiserettes, ladies and gentlemen, performing for you. Once again, each team has 13 minutes to do their best stuff in front of the crowd, and also to impress the judges in the hope that they might take home the award money and also the trophies. But the most important thing to these drill teams is just to perform for you, the home crowd, and also the crowd here in person. Jimmy Griffin Stadium in St. Paul, behind St. Paul Central High School on Lexington and Marshall. A great school in the city of St. Paul. Great field, named after a great man, Jimmy Griffin. From Des Moines, Iowa, getting a nice warm applause for their great talent that they just displayed to us. And up next will be the Oak Park Drill Team. You'll be seeing them in just a minute, ladies and gentlemen. Oak Park Wildcats. They come from Minneapolis, Minnesota, our own home team. ...1995 Rondo Days Drill Team Competition. Our next group is the Oak Park Wildcats from Minneapolis, Minnesota. Coming out in a nice purple and white outfits. The group that just left the field was the Isiserettes from Des Moines, Iowa. Being announced now is, once again, Oak Park Wildcats from Minneapolis, Minnesota. There they go. Oak Park Wildcats, purple and white, Minneapolis, Minnesota. At the 1995 Rondo Drill Team Competition. Oak Park Wildcats. love all these drill teams. They all try their best to put on a good show for the crowd. And they all did months, hours, weeks, minutes of practice for this competition. Once again, Oak Park Wildcats from Minneapolis. Of 3,000. We believe the stadium holds 3,500. We believe we have 3,000. We still have people trying to come in through the entrance to the stadium to see this competition. As I said before, this is the largest African-American drill team competition in the state of Minnesota. Drill teams and drum and bugle corps. Drum and bugle corps have horns. They are more in the line of major university marching bands. They do different types of performances where they will actually kind of play out a play of sorts or play music from an opera or something like that. These drill teams take the sounds that are from their neighborhood, take dances that they do throughout the year that they learn, that they create, put them to the music, and make a special performance out of those two things. That's the difference between drum and bugle corps and drill team. Once again, Oak Park Wildcats, Minneapolis, Minnesota. Oak Park Wildcats, ladies and gentlemen. Crowds going wild. Oak Park Wildcats. Park Wildcats, ladies and gentlemen, performing for you at home and for the crowd here at the 1995 Remember Rondo Days Drill Team Competition. The crowd keeps flowing in to the stadium. They love the drill team. They love to see young ladies and young men, boys and girls, march. They love it. And there they go, they're marching off. Oak Park Wildcats. City Pride Drill Team, dressed in black and gold. Upstart team, second performance at Rondo, their first performance at the 1994 Rondo Drill Team Competition. That's where they had their start, ladies and gentlemen. Teams are popping up all over the Twin Cities so they can perform for you at home and for the crowd here, and also to be at the 1996 Rondo Drill Team Competition. Teams are sprouting up everywhere. And as I said, for the little delay we had some famous rap group come through by the name of Naughty by Nature. As I said before, City Pride Drill Team is a strict, straight up, military style drill marching group. Not military as in the sense as a real military of our country, but in the style that they're without sound, except for their hands, feet, and cadence that they call out. Let's listen closely. The stadium is crowded, ladies and gentlemen. It's almost filled to capacity. I just got word that the step that the City Pride Drill Team is doing at this time is called Soul Patrol. This is the City Pride Drill Team from St. Paul, Minnesota. that cadence nice and loud. Music is their feet, hands, and cadence that they yell out. So let's listen closely, ladies and gentlemen. Giving the city pride to a team and plan as they march off the field at this time, ladies and gentlemen. City Pride drill team. Another upstart group, as I said before. Teams are growing out of the woodwork in the Twin City area. And that's nice to see. These young kids need more things to keep them occupied during the summer months, during the winter months, when they're not in school. Most of these students here are A and B honor roll students. Or they will not be allowed to be on most of these drill teams. And coming up next, ladies and gentlemen, from Kansas City is the Kansas City Pythons coming up next, marching onto the field. And we're at the 1995 Rondo Days drill team competition. Dressed in the green and gold from KC, the Pythons. Once again, my name is Bobby Johnson, as your announcer. And for anyone that's at home, make sure you make the next Rondo Days drill team competition and festival. Drill teams are choosing the option of not performing on their mat that was brought to the stadium for them because it is wet from earlier rains today. And that is an option that they have to choose from. Ladies and gentlemen, in the green and gold, Kansas City Pythons from KC, Kansas City, Missouri. This group last year, the 1994 Rondo Days drill team competition, took third place. Third place. You know they're back to even better than at this time.
Oh,
Pythons from Kansas City, Missouri, ladies and gentlemen. Performing for the crowd here at the 1995 Rondo Days Drill Team Competition and for you at home. This is what Rondo's all about, ladies and gentlemen. Our community and our youth. Rondo Days Drill Team Competition. This is our fourth group tonight. We have a total of 9 groups total. We're at the halfway mark, ladies and gentlemen. We're out here under the lights. This makes it even more special to be under the lights in the stadium. As you can see, this group chose to perform in front of the mat and not on the mat at this time. Rondo board member, also our entertainment chairman for the stage at the festival. Rondo Day is an all-day event. Starts from 10 o'clock in the morning, which is our parade, till this evening's festivities, which ends approximately around 10 p.m. Due to the rain, we have been delayed. Ending will be a little bit longer this evening. Well, I'm looking out at the skies at this time, and it looks like it's going to stay clear. We hope. We want to take this time to thank Cable Access and Cable Television for performing a well-deserved job. Coming out under these time restraints and recording this for you at home and for us here at the stadium. Just love when they move around, play the drums. The crowd really loves it. I also would like to take a little time out and thank the Star and Tribune African American Forum for volunteering their time and helping us all day. And without them, a lot of this stuff wouldn't go organized as it is at this time. Performing for you at this time is the Kansas City Pythons from Kansas City, Missouri. go. Kansas City Pythons. Beautiful. Gold and green. Next for your performance would be the First Step Marching Drill Team from Minneapolis, Minnesota. If this competition goes on, rain or shine. Here they go, First Step to the City from Minneapolis. Gentlemen, people are still coming in through the gates. We have five teams that have performed. They're still coming through the gates, ladies and gentlemen. This is how big this is in the Twin City area. And I might add, coming from the East Coast myself, it's big. They're awesome. And I assume all over the United States. Hopefully, we can have teams from different areas come to the Twin Cities to perform for you in the years to come.
I apologize. So, you didn't lie, man. I'm sorry.
Once again, there they go. City Pride, First Step in the City, drill team from Minneapolis. This time in the competition, we have three more drill teams left to perform. Hopefully we can get that in before the rains come. The clouds aren't looking too friendly. But rain or shine, the competition will go on. Competition, ladies and gentlemen, we have judges, five of them to be exact, hidden throughout the crowd so that the drill team does not perform to one side of the stadium only or to one section of the stadium only. We inform you that the judges are throughout the stadium so that they twist, turn, move around, and perform to both sides to make both groups of people on each side of the stadium happy. As you see throughout the evening, they have been in different locations, some on the mat, some in front, some on the side of the mat. Young ladies take time out of their schedules during school season, during the summer hours to practice, to make themselves better at their performance, to get the steps down, get the precision, the flamboyancy that's going to take them to the top at the Rondo 1995 Drill Team Competition. They drill anywhere from 2 hours to 3 hours, three times out of the week. Some groups, 5 days out of the week, some seven. It differs from each group, leader. But all these kids' hearts are in this. And as I said before, they're very good students and very good sportsmen. This is the 1995 Rondo Days Drill Team Competition. Once again, as you're announced, my name is Bobby Johnson. And I'm a Rondo Drill Team board member. Tonight, these drill teams will be drilling for cash awards as well as three trophies that the Rondo Days Board of Directors is delivering to them. Three beautiful trophies. Cash awards amounts for first place is $300, second and third place, $250. Correction, I was told $300 for first place, $150 for second and third. Griffin Stadium under the beautiful lights, watching the Rondo Days Drill Team Competition. We have three groups left to perform at this time. Six have already gone, including, as you're watching right now, First Step in the City, Drill Team from Minneapolis, Minnesota. know, young man throwing flips. As I said, these kids work hard. And it shows today at Rondo. There they are, first step in the city. Some drummers there playing their hearts out. There they go. First step in the city, ladies and gentlemen. Minneapolis is on. We have Rachel, who has next to her Major Tops from First Step in the City. Here's Rachel.
Thanks, Bobby. I'm Rachel from Cable Access St. Paul, and I have Major Tops here with First Step in the City from Minneapolis. You guys look great out there. How often do you have to practice and prepare for an event like this?
We practice 5 days a week and practice throughout the year to get the young people ready to just come and have a good time. It's competitive, but we tell them that they're having fun.
Well, it looks like they're having fun. How many other events and competitions do you take part in?
Oh, we take part in the Aquatinia. We go to southern and northern Minnesota. We came in third place last year in the Bud Billigan Parade in Chicago. We'll be in Rock Island, Illinois in the competition. We go all over and just share what the Lord has blessed us with.
Well, that's great. You guys look great out there, and best of luck to you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Back to you, Bobby.
Thank you, Rachel. And that was Major Tops. First Step in the City drill team from Minneapolis, Minnesota at the 1995 Rondo Days competition. And here comes the Falcons, last year's champions, led by Nature's Eligibility this time. Falcons are right here from St. Paul, Minnesota. There goes a camera shot of the crowd once more under the lights. We're so happy that it's not as humid as and as hot as it was the last few days before the rain came in. And now we're hoping that the rain holds off a little bit longer until we get finished with the last two groups. Correction, last three groups. We have three more groups, ladies and gentlemen, that will perform tonight. That's a total of 10 for this evening. And here comes the Falcons at the Rondo Days drill team competition. There goes some young people doing flips for you, some young men. You know that took practice. Once again, this is last year's champions at the 1994 drill team competition, the Falcons. The Falcons, 1994 drill team champions of last year. I want to send a shout out to Miss LaVere Daisy for singing the National Negro Anthem here at today's drill team competition. Thank you, LaVere. see from the camera shot, the stadium is crowded, ladies and gentlemen. People are still sprinkling in, two at a time. So crowded here today. The concession stand is closed at this time. They sold out of all their drinks and foods. Let's listen a little bit to the Falcons from St. Paul. Washington, group leader of the Falcons. Rondo Days, drill team competition, ladies and gentlemen. And in front of you at this time is the Falcons drill team. Thank you. to it real nice and smooth. This is going to be a tough competition, ladies and gentlemen. It's going to be hard for the judges to pick the champion of the 1995 Rondo Days Drill Team Competition. A lot of talent out there, a lot of it. All these groups have worked hard, and to me, and I'm sure to you at home and to the fans here in the stadium, either they're from the home state or from states out of town, all these young people are champions this evening. And I'd like to send a special thank you out to them for staying with us through the rain and performing this late into the evening. It shows their heart and character of all these young people this evening. Ladies and gentlemen, the Falcons from St. Paul. It's about to be a beautiful day. The rain has cooled it off. I'm sure the crowd is thankful and grateful for that. As we all know, it has been hot. 101 degree days, 99 degree days. And there they go, the Falcons from St. Paul, Minnesota, last year's champions. Minneapolis, ladies and gentlemen, is this group's first year in competition. They started here at Rondo. Correction, they were at Juneteenth this year, ladies and gentlemen. Let's go over in Minneapolis area. First year team, ladies and gentlemen, sound wonderful. Sound real good. Look at them, little kids, big kids. Strong parent support. Kids can grow up, be anything they want to be, ladies and gentlemen. It's what it's all about. Community and unity. Concentration on their faces, ladies and gentlemen. They're out there having fun and doing what they love to do. perform for crowds. Practice makes perfect. Again, for the people who might have missed the name, this is the Minneapolis owned Elks Music Makers. First year in competition. And we're at the Jimmy Griffin Stadium behind Central High School under the lights. And it's a beautiful sight, ladies and gentlemen. Young man go. One of the latest dances that the young youth do today. Get the crowd on their side, get the judges on their side, hoping to be the 1995 Rondo Days drill team champions. The Elk Music Makers from Minneapolis, Minnesota. Right there in front of your eyes is homegrown talent in the Twin Cities. To leave at this time, ladies and gentlemen, the Elks Music Makers from Minneapolis, Minnesota, homegrown talent. Here they come, ladies and gentlemen, United Steppers from St. Paul. This group has also been an assistant for 2 years, starting out last year was their first year, ladies and gentlemen. And they started here at Rondo Days. Looks like the skies are staying friendly for us at this time. United Steppers have chosen to use the mat for their performance, ladies and gentlemen. I'm sure the crowd loves that. United Steppers from St. Paul, Minnesota. Even at this late hours, ladies and gentlemen, the crowd is still here. They enjoy this. You're here to see all the drill teams. Like I said, they're all champions. This group has pom-pom girls, as some of the other groups did. Once again, doing cadence. Sights and sounds of the 1995 Rondo Days Drill Team Competition. Performing at this time is the United Steppers of St. Paul in the purple and black. We'll be announcing the winners, first, second, and third place awards this evening, ladies and gentlemen. After the last group has performed, we will be announcing the teams that have taken first, second, and third place. Still into this late evening. Fans are coming and going. We're at the end of another Rondo Days Festival / Drill Team competition for the 12th consecutive year. At this time, I think it's only right to mention that we should give a welcome round of applause to the Rondo Board, who puts this competition and festival on year after year. In case you were away from your TV set when I mentioned it before, this is the United Steppers from St. Paul. Thank you. again, our cameramen are right on it. Have to give them a big thank you. Excellent camera crew from Continental Cable and Cable Access here in St. Paul, Minnesota. As I said, some of these groups use a lot of music. Some of these groups use music, and they also use their hands and feet to demonstrate their flamboyancy and their precision. Steppers from St. Paul. Ladies and gentlemen, they're coming out from the side, ladies and gentlemen, from the North Bleachers. African Perfection is coming out from the North Bleachers from the side with a cloud of smoke. There they go. The crowd is now out of the stands. They're down on the track, ladies and gentlemen. Looks like this is going to be another great performance as we have had all night and all day. coming out in their army fatigues with t-shirts as African Perfection, 1993 drill team champions. This is our last group for this evening, and we will be announcing the winners. My name is Bobby Johnson, as your announcer. And this is the Rondo Days Drill Team Competition. The crowd's going wild, ladies and gentlemen. It's going to be a tough decision for the judges tonight. I already know that. I knew that from when the first two groups came out. It was going to be tough to pick number one, because they're all number one. This group here is led by Mr. George Johnson. This evening at this time, ladies and gentlemen, but you can best believe those young men, they're not feeling a bit of it. They're hyped, they want to perform, they were the last team, they were waiting. They're hot at this time, ladies and gentlemen. not feel none of this cool air. It even feels good to me. They have me pumped. I love stuff like this. Jackson Thriller here, ladies and gentlemen. Got the wolf costume on and everything. Crowd's going wild, ladies and gentlemen. As I mentioned before, for the guys that weren't on your TV sets or just came home, there was a newborn baby born at the gates of the stadium this evening at the 1995 Rondo Days Drill Team Competition. It's all about community, ladies and gentlemen. Unity in both cities, together and separate. Unity of all people. That's what Rondo Days is about, community. Town to come back home to the Twin Cities for this event. A lot of people have family reunions based around Rondo Days. It's all about family. And we're all one big family. Said drill teaming consists of modern dances, up-to-date dances, music that these kids listen to, the beats, sounds that their parents have listened to, and they combine them into an art form. Street precision dance, better known as drilling. I believe that they might be getting ready to leave the field at this time. I might be a step ahead. It looks like they're getting ready to formation, leave the field. And if that is so, coming up in a few minutes would be the announcement of our top three finishers at the 1995 Rondo Days Drill Team Competition. And yes, ladies and gentlemen, they are leaving the field at this time. They're going to settle the crowd that's still around, as you see. People are still here this late in the evening. This is the sights and sounds of Rondo all around us. Thank you. African Perfection Drill Team, St. Paul, Minnesota. Weather broke for us so we can do this competition, bring it to you, our cable access fans. This is what Remembering Rondo's all about, unity in both cities together. Practice all year long. It takes countless of hours to get the precisions of these steps down, to get the beats of the music down, and to be able to dance and drill to it. These kids love to perform. I'm holding that, ladies and gentlemen. Practice. Waiting for that beat to move. That one sound.